Good morning, everyone. We joyfully welcome you to St. Mary Parish as we celebrate Mass for the 33rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. A special welcome to those who are visiting or returning to public Mass with us for the first time. Please scan the QR codes in front of you with your smart device's camera. A link to the readings, prayers, and music will show up on your mobile devices so we can all participate together. However, please make sure your devices are on silent out of respect for the liturgy. Now we invite you to please stand and raise your voices in our opening song, In the Day of the Lord.
Good morning and welcome to this liturgy this morning. This morning's liturgy will be facilitated by the students in the third grade and of course also their instructors. So we gather this morning with them and their families in a very, very special way. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, amen. May the grace and the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Today's readings recall that the earth will someday end. When? Nobody knows. But it will happen. When there's a beginning, there's an end. We have nothing to fear. We come to the Lord and we present ourselves to Him. But we know that we are not perfect. There's things in our life that we regret, and we ask the Lord's forgiveness as we say, You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us raise our voices in praise to Almighty God as we sing.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people. We glorify you, we give you thanks for you.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. In those days, I, Daniel, heard this word of the Lord. At that time, there shall arise Michael, the great prince, guardian of your people. It shall be a time unsurpassed in distress, since nations begin until that time. At that time, your people shall escape, everyone who is found written in the book. Many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake. Some shall live forever. Others shall be in everlasting horror and disgrace. But the wise shall shine brightly like the splendor of the firmament, and those who led the many to justice shall be like the stars forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning, everyone. We joyfully welcome you to St. Mary Parish as we celebrate Mass for the 33rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. A special welcome to those who are visiting or returning to public Mass with us for the first time. Please scan the QR codes in front of you with your smart device's camera. A link to the readings, prayers, and music will show up on your mobile devices so we can all participate together. However, please make sure your devices are on silent out of respect for the liturgy. Now, we invite you to please stand and raise your voices in our opening song, In the Day of the Lord.
Good morning and welcome to this liturgy this morning. This morning's liturgy will be facilitated by the students in the third grade and of course also their instructors. So we gather this morning with them and their families in a very, very special way. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, amen. May the grace and the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Today's readings recall that the earth will someday end. When? Nobody knows. But it will happen. When there's a beginning, there's an end. We have nothing to fear. We come to the Lord and we present ourselves to Him. But we know that we are not perfect. There is things in our life that we regret, and we ask the Lord's forgiveness as we say. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us raise our voices in praise to Almighty God as we sing.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people.
We glorify you, we give you thanks for you.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. In those days, I, Daniel, heard this word of the Lord. At that time, there shall arise Michael, the great prince, guardian of your people. It shall be a time unsurpassed in distress, since nations begin until that time. At that time, your people shall escape, everyone who is found written in the book. Many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake. Some shall live forever. Others shall be in everlasting horror and disgrace. But the wise shall shine brightly like the splendor of the firmament, and those who led the many to justice shall be like the stars forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, every priest stands daily at his ministry, offering frequently those same sacrifices that can never take away sins. But this one offered one sacrifice for sins and took his seat forever at the right hand of God. Now he waits until his enemies are made his footstool. For by one offering he has made perfect forever those who are being consecrated. Where there is forgiveness of these, there is no longer offering for sin. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said to his disciples, "In those days, after that tribulation, the sun will be darkened, the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from the sky, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. And then he will send out his angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the end of the earth to the end of the sky. Learn a lesson from the fig tree. When its branches become tender and sprout leaves, you know that summer is near. In the same way, when you see these things happening, know that he is near at the gates. Amen, I say to you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But at that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father." The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. This morning, we know that the third grade is facilitating this liturgy. We heard two great readers, and we commend them. They read the readings with clarity and very well. And I'd like to ask a couple of questions to the third graders, because I understand that you are the most intelligent third graders that ever passed through this parish. You think that's true? I hope. Hey, come on, be alive. Give me some response, okay? Yes, okay, go. Who can tell me what we are going to celebrate, holidays we're going to celebrate in the next, 6 weeks? What's going to happen 2 weeks from now? Thanksgiving. And what's going to happen in the month of December? Oh, then all hands go up. Christmas. Now, how do we know that Thanksgiving is going to happen 2 weeks from now and that Christmas is going to happen in December? How do we know that? Who tells us that? Where is it written? You forgot your answer. That happens to me too. I forget my answer. I forget my name sometimes. Huh? What? Yeah, what?
Jesus.
Jesus. I didn't take the mask off for a minute.
Jesus.
Jesus?
Yeah.
Yeah, but why do we know that next 2 weeks from now, 10 days from now, we're going to be celebrating Thanksgiving? And then next month, on a certain day, we're going to celebrate Christmas. Calendar, right? The calendar tells us what's going to happen in the future. Right? A lot of things. What else can be on the calendar? You're all on the calendar someplace. What is that day? Your birthday's on a calendar, right? What's your birthday? July 8th, okay? So July 8th, it's going to be your birthday. And what's your birthday? October what? 19th, okay. Okay, send all these kids those birthday cards on those dates, okay? So those are the calendars. Calendars are very, very important for everybody, okay? Because it's dates. Your birthdays, your parents' birthdays, what is another very important, especially for your parents?
Mother's Day,
Father's Day. How about their wedding day? Huh? That's an important day. When's your birthday? April 10th. Okay, don't forget. April 10th, that's another one. All kinds of dates, right, are very, very important. And it's been that way for, well, since people have been on Earth. Originally, I'm sure that people had some kind of a calendar to tell them that it was time to plant seeds, their crops, in the springtime. Jesus says in the gospel this morning, you know when spring will come, when the fig tree will start to bud. We know that. In the springtime, we go out and daffodils come out of the ground. We're saying, well, spring is here, right? How do we know that winter is here? Come on. Somebody else that didn't answer yet. How do you know winter is here? Oh, come on. Please, snow, right? Winter is here because I came to church this morning with a jacket on. It's getting colder. I got in the car this morning, there was frost on the windshield. Okay, we don't have that in the summer, right? Right, these are things, they're signs of things, okay? And what the gospel today is telling us, that if the world began, what's the conclusion? What do you think is going to happen one day? It's going to be what? It's going to end, right? It's just like, unfortunately, we don't like to look at that, but if we're born, right, what's going to happen eventually, hopefully many, many years from now, what's going to happen to most people, all people? Huh? Oh, come on. If people are born, what's going to happen? They're going to die. And that's not a bad thing, because we go back to Jesus. We came from Jesus the day we're born, and that's on the calendar. But what's not on the calendar is the day that we're going to go back to Jesus. And that's not, we're going to cry, we're going to be sad, but it's not the end. We're going to miss the people. Maybe you've had grandparents that have died already, and you miss them. Or unfortunately, maybe even a parent. And during this pandemic, a lot of people have, millions of people have died around the world, and they are missed, but they are with God, okay? But the problem is, when we look at the past calendar, we know what happened, right? You all know that you were born on a certain date. But what happens in the future calendar? Are you happy about that? Go ahead. Oh, yeah, future calendar way down the road. I hope it's a long time for you and for many of us. But what are you happy about the future? As happy? Why? Yeah, we're going to go back to Jesus. But hopefully most of us are not right away, right? But when we look at a calendar, the past calendar, we're okay with that because we know what happened. But next week I'm going to go to Staples and I'm going to buy myself my desk calendar for 2022. And I'm going to put down all the anniversaries, all the dates that I want to remember, okay? But I don't know what else is going to happen. It's the unknown. And because it's the unknown, sometimes we're scared, we're frightened. We don't know what's going to happen. And some people looking at the world in which we live today and saying, it's a terrible world we live in. Look at all the crime that's around us, you know? There's all kinds of wars going on. Some people in some countries, like in Madagascar, they've suffered a 5-year drought. Millions are dying of starvation. There's no food. In other places, there's wars. There's places around the world that big floods, hurricanes, on and on, tornadoes. I was at the church in Plainville last night, and all of a sudden the alarm went off. Tornado watch, you know? So, you know, they have thunder and lightning. I'm sure you had that in Wrentham, you know? But there was a tornado watch, and I told the people, well, we better get ready. If it sounds again, we'll all have to go in the basement of the church. That's the future. From one minute to the other, we didn't know what was going to go on, okay? It's scary, because we've seen that in the past. If there was a tornado, the church could have been swept away. Hopefully, we'd be all in the basement of the church safe. But when we look to the future, we do not know what's going to happen. It's the unknown. We don't know, for instance, how bad COVID is going to get again, right? You're all wearing masks this morning, right? That's not the way it was. And hopefully in next year or a couple of months from now, you won't have to wear a mask, right? In your church, in your school, have you ever had a if they say, if somebody comes into the school with a gun, for instance, like it's happened, have you all, they told you what to do? Huh? What are you gonna do? You're right under your desk and you try to barricade the door? Okay. That's new. A few years ago, we didn't have to worry about people coming into the school with guns. I hope you're not afraid of that, but in case it ever happened, you know what to do. If a tornado came, I think the same thing, you would get under your desk. When I was your age, there was a scare of the atomic bomb because of what happened, and they told us the same thing, get under your desk. I don't know if that would save us, but you know. But I remember that, you know, get under your desk, and we would have practice, okay? But what we are doing this week is almost at the end of the year. We talked about calendars. We're in another calendar right now, what's called the liturgical year. The new year, liturgical year, will begin 2 weeks from now, Advent. And what we celebrate in the liturgical year is all the great mysteries of our faith. The hundreds of years before Jesus, Jesus' birth. What's the date that we're going to celebrate? What's the date? A number.
December 25th.
December 25th. Okay. That's what we celebrate, Jesus' birthday. But then later on, what's the next big feast after Christmas? Jesus went, and we're going to celebrate that. He lived, he preached, and what happened after that? Easter, right. So that's the next big date. And after that is Pentecost, the descent of the Holy Spirit. And from that date to now, it's 34 weeks. That we celebrate the time of the church, okay? All of that time is what we call not a regular calendar, Gregorian calendar, but a liturgical calendar. We celebrate the life of Jesus and what it means for us. But that calendar ends this week and next week. And so we say, if there's a beginning, there has to be a what? You should all have your hands up. Come on. Boy, if I was a teacher, I'd be very strict, wouldn't I? If there's a beginning, what is there? It has to be a what? And then, easy, right? That's life, okay? So there has to be an end. And the church celebrates that there will be an end. This beautiful world in which we live, but it's for us to take care of that world, right? we can make all the, we can cite all the problems of our world, and we can say if we want to preserve that world, and right now there's a big conference going on in Scotland about climate change. That's for you people especially, right? The young people of your generation. If we've caused damage to our planet, we have to take measures to save it before the end of the world. So the end of the world is not something that we have to be afraid of. I'm not, you know. Whenever it comes, it's gonna come. I can't do anything about it. And Jesus tells us in this gospel, we don't know the time or the hour or the day. It will come. And that's going to be a return to Jesus. But in the meantime, we just live the life the best we can. Right? As if it's going to be the last day. I'm sure if it was announced on the calendar that tomorrow is going to be the last day, I'm sure the parking lots at Lusler would be full of people running for confession, you know. But we don't have to worry if every day we do our best to live a good life, to remain good, to do your best, to live as in peace with your siblings, to honor your parents, to study the best you can, to be the best you can be. Is that clear? Easy, isn't it? That's what the gospel is really all about. You know, we don't have to be afraid when we go into a new year, a new calendar. We know certain days, but you don't know what's going to happen to you from now to your birthday. It might be wonderful things, hopefully, but God is with us no matter what happens during that year. That clear? You all agree to that? How about you old folks? Do you agree with that? How about a little bit more reaction from you people? Yes, Father. Okay. Let us now stand and renew our profession of faith as we say, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead in the life of the world to come. Amen. As we look to the future Christ has won for us, we see the purpose of our lives in the present more clearly, aware of the many needs in our church and in our world, let us bring our petitions before our just and merciful God.
For the Holy Catholic Church, for Francis our Pope, for Sean our Bishop, for our priests, Father Joe, Father Lambert, Father Bernie, and for all our deacons, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of the world, that they would work together to promote peace and justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our community, that we would serve others in all that we do and would work together to love others as Christ loved us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are sick, suffering, or in any kind of danger, that they would experience the healing power of Christ's love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for all the blessings in our lives, especially our families, friends, and teachers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, may they rest in peace with Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own needs and personal intentions that we now recall in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray for all our relatives, friends, and parishioners who have died, and those written in the parish's book of names. When the Lord of life returns in his glory, may they rise to the fullness of joy as Saint Michael leads them into God's presence. We also want to remember Ellen Walsh, who died recently, Margaret Connor, for whom a funeral mass will be celebrated at St. Mary on Saturday at 11 a.m., and especially for Adolf and Catherine Pardo, for whom this mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord. O God, who rules the world with justice and are the stronghold of our hope, hear our cry, and that of all who live with suffering or sorrow. For we unite them with the prayers of the saints, knowing your plan for our future and our salvation. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. We have a couple of announcements. The second collection this week is the regular building fund collection. Please help us maintain our commitment to paying off the St. Mary mortgage in the next couple of years. We ask all lectors that you pick up your new lector workbook, which is available today at the main entrance. Your old book expires next weekend, so be sure to take a new one today. Our Plainville-Wrentham Collaborative is hosting the Ecumenical Thanksgiving Service this year. Come join in prayer with our sisters and brothers in Christ as we all give thanks to God on November 23, Tuesday of Thanksgiving week, at 7:30 p.m. here at St. Mary's. The children's choir is starting rehearsals this weekend after the 9:30 Mass. Any interested child should meet in the choir area. If your child cannot attend this Sunday, please contact Jillian to confirm your child wants to be involved. Our monthly parish blood pressure clinic takes place after this Mass. For today only, it will be in the Parish Center Conference Room. All are invited to take this quick step to be good stewards of the body God gave us. Also after this Mass, all are invited to join the class hosting this Mass for donuts and coffee and juice downstairs in the church hall. Please stay a few moments to get to know other members of our parish family. And for more of these and other spiritual and practical information, please take home a bulletin, check our website, pwc.church, for updates. Thank you.
And as we gather our gifts to the Lord, please join in our offertory song, Give Me Jesus.
Pray, my brothers and my sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave life to eternity. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of our faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, in all the clergy and religious. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
sometimes beginning a new calendar year or looking towards the future, it can be fearful because we don't know what's going to happen. There might be wonderful things, but there might be also sad situations. But we are all called to go into the future with faith and with trust to Almighty God, for He goes with us. And so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us now offer each other some sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should come under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ preserve us all to life everlasting. Amen.
and watchful through the night, for my kingdom come in light. Heirs to the glory of the Lamb. What mighty word of truth, what message rise in triumph. Now he sits upon the throne, God's right hand is he alone. Christ reigns in splendor over all. One banquet richly set for all God's holy people. We will dine in joy and peace, and our song will never cease, praising the Lamb upon the throne. One shout of joy we a prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. We humbly have partaken of the gifts of the sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth and charity. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace and in love to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks.
Just a couple of reminders. The young people who want to join the young choir to please stay after Mass, but also all of us are invited to downstairs for refreshments hosted by the third grade. Have a great day and a great week.
And as we are sent forth, please join in our recessional song, He is Exalted.
The King is exalted.